Namaste and welcome everyone. One of the biggest reasons why most people are interested in leading a meditative life or wanted to learn about meditation is because they want to get rid of excessive thinking or overthinking. Excessive thinking, overthinking, also called as a monkey mind, is basically the tendency, the subconscious tendency of the mind to move from one thought to another. It's an internal dialogue that is taking place within us at all times. It could be in the form of ideas, imaginations, stories, fantasies, daydreamings, etc., etc. And there's nothing wrong in it because that is the natural state or default programming of the mind, is that it has to go from one thought to another, just like the monkey runs, goes from one branch to another branch. That's why it's called the monkey mind. Now, we realize that this is a problem, that this pattern of the mind is a problem, only when this mind meets a trigger that initiates an emotional response within us. So what I mean by that is, when there is a situation that is not favorable to us, which we feel is very threatening to us in some way, maybe it's concerning our health, maybe it's concerning money, maybe it's concerning our children, maybe concerning our parents, whatever the reason could be, that's the time we realize that the mind is not cooperating with us. We want to shift the thought and shift the feeling, but we can't. That helplessness we find ourselves because we haven't, because the nature of the mind is such and we haven't done anything about it. So we must therefore take steps right away to deal with the situation. We should not wait for an emotion to arise because and then to create all these unwanted sensations in the body, the contractions in the body, to deal with it. We have to believe and train ourselves, our mind, right away so that we can address this issue when we are triggered in some way. Okay. So how are we going to do this? So there are two basic ways to deal with the situation, or how to train our mind. The first is aloof witnessing. Develop the habit of aloof witnessing. One thought comes, allow that thought to move out. Another thought comes, allow it to go out. You watch it come, you watch it go. You watch it come, you watch it go. Don't get caught up into the story. Don't try to juice it. Don't try to milk that thought. Because that's the tendency of the mind. So we have to go against the tendency of the mind. Okay? So that's the first basic thing. That most of these thoughts that we are thinking is mere projection of the mind. So we just simply allow through witnessing to come and move through us and move out. Garbage in, garbage out. Remember, garbage in, garbage out. Garbage in, garbage out. That's the first way. The second way is of the way of the yogis. So what the yogis do is they train their self in such a manner that they don't allow the mind to draw too much life force into itself. It does not allow. What they do is they do pranayama. In pranayama, they control the breath in such a manner that it can keep the life force within itself and not and don't allow the mind to snatch the life force and draw the life force and drain us emotionally. And by doing that, they're able to keep the life force functioning in a very balanced manner within their body system. So as we know that there are basically five different kinds of energies within us, which are by the yogic science, which is called as five kinds of pranas, life force, which is prana, apana, bhyana, samana, udana. Each of these life force, they are responsible for a certain function in our bodies. Now, when the mind gets overwhelmed due to an emotion, it tries to draw excessive energy out of this and out of this life force system and disturbs and disrupts the life force energy. And that's the reason why many people fall ill. They start looking older with their age, before their age, and they start to feel very, very drained in their life and lethargic and lazy. So to prevent that, what the yogis do is they bring change in the breathing patterns. By changing the breathing patterns and and harnessing their breath in a positive manner, they're able to prevent the snatching of life force and to prevent themselves from illnesses, diseases and mental problems. So you should learn that from somebody who knows life force control and breath control through pranayama. So I hope I have addressed these two manners and the two ways, and you will implement that in your life in some way. Yeah. Thank you.